Well, just like us, birds need shelter to thrive. So do insects like bees. And if you want to help them, here's some advice.
Hi, Newsround. My name is Carl and I'm a head gardener with the National Trust. One of my favourite things to do in springtime is to make homes for wildlife. Today, I'm going to show you how you can do this for bees. When we think about bees in a garden, a lot of people go to the honeybee or they think about all the big bumblebees, but there's actually hundreds and hundreds of different kinds of bees. And my favourite ones are called solitary bees. Now, they need as much space to live in and survive in as all the other creatures in the garden. So a few ways that you can do this. First one, this is quite literally just a lump of wood from a garden fence that I put up. And all I've done is just drill holes of different sizes into it. Then hopefully that is a good place for solitary bees to have a little look in and lay some eggs. The other night, well, I had beans on toast for my dinner, and I thought, well, rather than throwing this out or putting in recycling, maybe I can turn it into a solitary bee home as well. This is the one I'm gonna show you how to make yourselves at home. Let's look at the materials that we need first. Earlier on today, I found lots of old stems from the plants like this. This is from a plant called a hydrangea, which I like to just, seeing that hole at the bottom there, I just poke this through. What that's gonna do is it's gonna help, when I start to push these in, it's kind of just gonna grip them a little bit and stop them falling out. If I just keep going, that's quite a nice one there. I might just snip down. If you're doing this at home, it'd be really good if you could get an adult to help you because these are very, very sharp. Another few minutes and then I'd have something that looks a little bit more like that. And then what I would do, I could just leave it on a shelf in the garden somewhere, or if there's a wall I can stick it to. Something that's about this high. So there you go. There's a nice easy way, very cheap way of making a solitary bee home in your gardens. Happy crafting. Bye.